गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू अवर ट्राइंगल चैप्टर, एग्जाम्पल नंबर 8, लास्ट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ 7th चैप्टर एंड एक्सरसाइज रिलेटेड टू 7.3। सी हियर, इट इज इन दिस एग्जाम्पल इट इज गिवन टू यू, पी इज अ पॉइंट इक्विडिस्टेंट फ्रॉम टू लाइन्स एल एंड एम इंटरसेक्टिंग एट पॉइंट ए। टू लाइन्स आर हेयर एल एंड एम, here one line they are intersecting and one line is crossing this, they are intersecting at point A. P is a point on this line equidistant from B and C, it means this one side is equal, given to you between them. Show that the line AP bisect the angle between them, it means we have to prove that BAP means this angle is equal to this one angle. So what is given to you? Given PA is equal to B is equal to PC and angle ABP is equal to angle ACP is equal to 90°. Given to us, prove that BAP is equal to CAP. Now we will start our proof. Two triangle, take in triangle BAP and triangle CAP. Angle B is equal to angle C is equal to 90°, given. PB is equal to PC, given. And if you see properly, then AP is equal to AP common. Whenever we have one angle 90°, then try to check that maybe it is RHS theorem we can apply here. This right angle opposite to this is equal, this is hypotenuse. So we can say this is hypotenuse and this one side, this is right angle. So it means which theorem we can apply? So triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP RHS theorem. If they are congruent, then by CPCT BAP is equal to CAP, reason is CPCT. This time we will prove this question. Okay, now we will take question number first of exercise 7.3. Question first, triangle ABC and triangle DBC, exercise 7.3, question first, triangle ABC and triangle DBC are two isosceles triangle, on the same base BC, and vertices A and D, are on the same side of BC, If AD is extended, to intersect BC at P, show that first triangle ABD, is congruent to triangle ACD. Second, triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP. Part third, AP bisects angle A as well as angle D. AP is the perpendicular bisector of BC. AP is perpendicular bisector of BC. Diagram. ABC DBC. Here it is given to you that ABC and DBC are two isosceles triangle on the same base BC. It means AB two sides AB and AC equal and DBC two sides DB and DC equal. Next given to you are vertices on the same side. AD is extended to this, show that ABD. ABD is congruent to ACD. How to show it? That ABD is congruent to ACD. Firstly, see here and then prove ABP is congruent to ACP. Anything else given to you? ABC and DBC are two isosceles triangle on the same base BC and vertices A and D on the same side of BC. If AD is extended to intersect BC at P, show that triangle ABD. Now see in these two triangles. Triangle ABD and triangle ACD. In these two triangles, AB is equal to AC given, DB is equal to BC given, because they are isosceles triangle. And if you see properly, then this AD is common. Then by triple S rule, we can say these two triangles are congruent. So what we can write down in solution? In triangle ABC, we can say AB is equal to AC, DBC, DB is equal to DC. Equation first, second, reason isosceles triangles. So now take in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, AB is equal to AC, DB is equal to DC, and third one, AD is equal to AD. These two given and this one common. So by triple S congruency rule, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. If they are congruent, now next we want to prove ABP is congruent to ACP. If they are congruent, then easily we can say that BAD angle is equal to CAD by CPCT. That is BAD is equal to CAD, reason CPCT. Now take triangle second, for the second part, in triangle ABP and triangle ACP. AB is equal to AC given, angle BA, this is equation first, BAP is equal to CAP from equation first, and AP is equal to AP from. See, whenever you take this one angle, this name if you write BAD or this name if you write BAP, doesn't matter. They both are equal, same thing. Then by SAS rule, triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP. Two parts proved, first and second. थर्ड सी नाउ यू हैव टू एपी बाइसेक्ट दिस वन एंगल फ्रॉम इक्वेशन फर्स्ट BAP is equal to CAP. It means AP bisects angle A. Okay. Now see, similarly, this complete angle, if I remove it, that we can say two triangles. One triangle, this one. I write A. And one triangle, this one, B. Subtract. From B to A, then triangle ABP minus triangle ABD congruent to triangle ACP minus triangle ACD. Sorry, areas if we are taking. Okay, see here. Similarly, can you prove that these two triangle congruent? Yes or no? This is common. ABP. This one congruent, it means I can write down BP is equal to PC. Then now take these two triangle. In triangle BDP and triangle CDP. BD is equal to CD. BP is equal to PC. DP is equal to DP. So by triple S rule we can say these two triangle also congruent. Or if they are congruent, then obviously by CPCT BDP is equal to CDP. Then we can say that AP bisect angle D also. Means if we prove these two angles are equal, it means this line bisect angle D also. Okay, till here complete. Third part, AP is a perpendicular bisector of BC. Perpendicular means we have to prove these angles equal to 90 degree. Bisector means BP is equal to PC. Then BP is equal to PC we already proved. Give any equation, it is equation number second. Then we can write down in triangle APB and triangle, write down here, in triangle APB and triangle APC, angle APB is equal to angle APC, but angle APB plus angle APC is equal to 180 degree, reason linear pair. Then we can write down twice of APB is equal to 180 degree, then angle APB is equal to 90 degree, is equal to we can say APC, and we know BP is equal to PC. From these two things we can say that AP is a perpendicular bisector of BC. Now here last part also proof. So firstly we prove. So, firstly you given to you that ABC, ABD and ABC and DBC are isosceles triangle. Then AB is equal to AC, DB is equal to DC. So, in these two triangle AD common, by triple S rule these two triangle congruent. Then after these angles are equal by CPCT. Now APB and APC by SAS rule these two triangle congruent. Then BP is equal to PC and APB is equal to APC. They are making linear pair. That's why sum of these two angle is equal to 180 degree. Then each angle is equal to 90 degree. So we can say AP is the perpendicular bisector of BC. Okay, student. Now see the last question. Two sides AB and BC. Question number third. of 7.3 exercise. Two sides AB and BC and median AM and median AM of one triangle ABC of one triangle ABC are respectively equal to sides PQ and QR and median PN. PQ and QR and median of triangle PQR show that triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN. First, second, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Two sides AB and BC and median AM of one triangle. It means we make two triangles. ABCPQR median it is given to you median what is the median here median kya hoti hai median is a line segment draw from any vertex to the opposite sides which divides the opposite sides into two equal parts or we can say median is a line segment by joining any vertex to the midpoint of the opposite side it means here m and n are the midpoints of bc and qr midpoints means bm is equal to mc and qn is equal to nr what is given to you two sides AB and BC this complete sides AB this complete side BC and median AM of one triangle are equal to the sides PQ QR this complete side QR and this one side then prove that ABM is congruent to PQN and ABC is congruent to PQR firstly see solution we can say given AB is equal to PQ BC is equal to QR AM is equal to P. This is given. Prove that these two part. Then we start our proof. AM median AM on side BC. So. We can say that BM is equal to MC or is equal to half of BC. PN is median on side QR. So QN is equal to NR is equal to half of QR. Given BC is equal to QR, then half of BC
is equal to half of QR. Half of BC means BM, and this one we can say QM equal. This is equation first. Now take in triangle ABM and triangle PQM. In what triangle? AB is equal to PQ, BM is equal to QN from equation first given, and AM is equal to PN given. So by which rule? That triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN by triple S congruency rule. If they are congruent, then we can say angle B is equal to angle Q using CPCT. Now we take two triangle ABC and PQR. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR, this is equation second. AB is equal to PQ given, BC is equal to QR given, angle B is equal to angle Q, this is given, and this one is from equation second. Then by SAS rule, we can say triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. This type we can do proof. Median is what here? Median concept, that median is a line segment by joining any vertex to a midpoint of opposite side. This is called a median. It means M is midpoint here of BC. It means BM is equal to MC. N is midpoint here. QN is equal to NR, is equal to half of the QR. This type we will prove this question. Okay student, 7.4 exercise and theorem related to 7.4 exercise is not in your syllabus this time. So that is the topic inequality of triangle. So till 7.3 complete your homework with examples and theorems also. Exercise all, theorems all, and examples all. Okay, thank you.